Greetings, and welcome to our CodeMeter tutorial series. With this tutorial, we will show you how to protect and license a modular .NET application, and thus create a protected feature-on-demand licensing scheme. For this purpose, we are going to use the same Notepad sample that we prepared for our previous tutorial, Protecting an Application with AxProtector.NET. The sample Notepad is a text application. When starting it, we can type in some text, for instance, Hello World, change the font, make it bold, and modify its size and its color. The main concept is to license a basic application with limited functionality and then be able to upsell an additional license for changing the font characteristics. In case you have not seen the previous tutorial protecting an application with AxProtector.NET, we recommend you stop this video and watch that first. That video tackles the basic protection steps, which we will not repeat again here. Instead, we will dive directly into the modular protection procedure. In this tutorial, we will cover two different aspects, security and user experience. We will demonstrate the security aspect first, and later on we'll take a look at the user experience. From a security point of view, in our earlier tutorial about firm code and product code, we showed that each product code comes with its own cryptographic key. To create the best possible protection, we choose a different product code for every functionality or feature that we want to license separately. Essentially, we have a separate cryptographic key for every functionality. In practice, we identify the methods in our application that are used for the different functionalities or features. These methods are specific segments in the executable code of our application. Then we assign the chosen product codes to those methods. In our sample, there's one method, changeFont, which we'll assign to the feature of changing the font characteristic. All other methods will be automatically assigned to the feature basic functionality. Now, let's see a live example. We start the AxProtector tool. We choose the .NET assembly option and drag and drop the unprotected application into AxProtector. On the next page, we can choose firm code and product code. We will choose the same codes that were used for the basic functionality in the first tutorial, firm code 6.000.947 and product code 201.000 for the software to start. We will skip over all the other settings because they are similar to those we used in the first tutorial. We now set the error messages to the default error messages and switch to these advanced options where we need to activate AxProtector, IP protection, and the WIBU Universal Protection Interface known as WUPI. This allows us to assign different product codes to different methods. We open up the advanced options and go to the license list page first. One license list can define multiple alternative licenses. In most cases, as well as in our sample, one license list includes one license defined by a firm code and a product code. Alternatively, licenses are mainly used when an ISV has multiple firm codes due to legacy reasons. Here we now define a second product code that we want to assign to the feature change font. Let's add the description change font and choose the firm code 6.000.947 and the product code 201.001. If the end user only receives the product code 201.000, he only owns the basic functionality. If he receives both 201.000 and 2001.001, he is entitled to use the basic functionality and the change font feature. On the next slide, we see all namespaces, classes, and methods in the software. Here we need to identify the functionalities and the methods that are connected to the change font feature. We know that the method change font belongs to the change font feature, so we assign license list 1, which we have just created on the previous page, to this method. Next, we can go to the summary page. Now the application is protected, and we see the AxProtector creates a subfolder called protected. In this subfolder, we find the protected sample Notepad application. If we don't have the appropriate key, we get the error message, basic license is required. Without the license, the software will not start. We have seen what happens when you start the software without any license. Now, let's take a look at what happens if we stop the software with a key for the basic license, but not for the change font feature. In this case, our software starts. If we click on change font in the menu, we see the error message about the missing license for the change font feature. We can press retry, but the system will not be able to detect the license because we have not purchased it. Alternatively, we can press cancel and the software will terminate itself. From a security perspective, with a small configuration of AxProtector, we made a very strong modular protected application, aka a protected application providing a feature on demand. However, we should look at the user experience as well to make the process more appealing. Having a button that terminates the software in case a feature is not licensed is not an elegant solution. To address this, we need to go to the source code, which we have already opened for your convenience. We first need to add two libraries, the WIBU-SYSTEMS and the WIBU.NET. The WIBU.NET is a library that defines some constants, a runtime and a development library. The WIBU-SYSTEMS is a library that is used during development. This library confirms that a specific feature is licensed and the end user can continue using your software. When the encryption is applied with AxProtector, this library is removed and replaced with the real functionality. With the encryption, we also implement the security check in your application. Now we can use WIBU-SYSTEMS. Let's go to the change font functionality. Instead of calling change font directly, we check if one of the alternative licenses of license list 1 is available. If so, we say yes, change font, and all works fine. If the license is not there, we display the message box, no license found accompanied by an error icon as a warning. Now, we recompile the application and re-encrypt it. We start the protected application and click the change font. We get the error message, license not found, but when we click OK, the software continues working and we can keep on using it. This is how to use the WIBU API, a simple API call to enhance the user experience while we use different cryptographic keys to achieve a strong security level. Sometimes we get asked if it's possible to remove or disable the button if the license is not there. The answer is yes, we can implement this. In the initialization code of our software, or in the background check, we verify if the WIBU check license is OK, and then we enable or disable the button here. We then recompile it, re-encrypt it, and start it. Due to the fact that the license is not there, the font button is disabled, so it will no longer function. Instead of just disabling it, we could remove it, or we could make it visible, invisible, or anything else that you may want. There is a second interesting question we get asked frequently. What happens if the ID1, which we are using in our source code, and the ID1, which we are defining here and assigning to the chain font feature in the graphical user interface, do not match? This is why we have the alternative option to set this with an attribute in the source code, rather than needing to do this manually in the AxProtector graphical user interface. Let's go to change font. We set an attribute which acts in such a way that this change font feature belongs to license list 1. In the source code, we are already marking that this is the functionality associated with license list 1, and before we are calling this functionality, we check for license list 1. Now it's in the hands of the developers to make sure that the references for the license list are the same during the check and for the encryption. Those using the AxProtector graphical user interface can remove the setting. After refreshing the page, we see that change font is marked with an attribute, and the status of this attribute tells us that it is connected to license list 1. Now we can perform the encryption again. Those executing encryption do not need to know which function belong to which license list because this is already marked by the developer in the source code. There is another option. In this case, we check the license, but what happens if we forget to perform the check before calling the functionality? Here, we can use exception handling. A sample for this case has also been prepared. Here we try to call our change font feature. If it does not respond, we catch the WIBU exception and display an error message. We now compile the application once again and go back to AxProtector. Since we don't want to terminate the host application, we go to Runtime Settings, Advanced Options, and remove the flag for terminating the host application. This means that the software should not be terminated when an error occurs. It should rather raise an exception, and we catch the exception. Now we need to re-encrypt the application. When starting the software and trying to change font, we get a message that the license for change font is not there. If we press cancel, we catch the exception and display the error message of the caught exception, so maybe we can skip one or the other. Then our software will still execute and the user can work with it. Thus we have shown how to protect and license modular feature on demand for .NET software. We have seen that there are several options available. You can use WIBU checks before you execute some additional functionality. You can rely on error handling and exception handling, and you can catch the error message when the protected functionality cannot be used. We have seen how to enable and disable buttons in our software, and we have seen how to assign cryptographic keys to this on-demand functionality to get the best available software protection. This concludes this segment of our CodeMeter tutorial series. Thank you very much for your interest in this short tutorial on protecting and licensing a modular application with AxProtector.NET, one of the modules from CodeMeter Protection Suite. And, as always, we wish you great success with CodeMeter and your business.